Okay, it's time to pack up the Stratocaster. And a couple things are going on. The guitar actually has to cross a border from Canada to the US, so there's a little bit of paperwork. There's some tricks to that so you don't get hosed. First thing on the list, let's tweak this up a little bit. If you're going to ship a guitar, don't detune it, just quarter turn, detune it. This is especially important for an acoustic guitar. That's perfect. If the package takes a big fucking hit, and the guitar's tuned to pitch, that can surely help break the neck. So, with that in mind, just detune it a little bit. Next little trick that I'm going to do. Just perchance, you win the lottery. And that's basically how it works. And the customs guys want to open the package because they love to do that shit. And then when they open it up and they find out it's a guitar, well, lots of times they'll screw with it. But when it's completely encapsulated in cellophane, like I'm doing now, there's two things that can happen. They'll give up and not screw with it. But if they really, really want to screw with it, well, guess what, guys? I can tell they did. And the person at the other end can tell they did too. So that's my trick for today. Okay, so I didn't mummify it. Right, another trick you can use is paper, like tissue paper. Just gently wrap the guitar in tissue paper, and that way you can tell if anybody's dicked with it or opened it. You know, if they open the box and they see it's a guitar and they can't screw with it, usually they'll walk away. Just put it back, hopefully the way it was packed. Okay, next, it's in the bag. I am going to bubble wrap the entire bag before it goes in the box over there. Okay, so we're all saran wrapped, bubble wrapped, taped up. At this point, even if this package was left out in the weather and got soaking wet, your guitar inside would probably still be just perfect. So, we gotta get it in the box, and let's get that part done. So if it was in a hard case, I wouldn't worry too much about this. But what I'm gonna do, right at the bottom, we're gonna put some stiff foam. And we're gonna tell them to make it ride this way up. We know they're gonna fucking lay it down, but that's all you can do, right? Do not stack. They'll put this on the bottom of a pile of shit and put a ton of stuff on top. So, I prefer a triple wall cardboard box. This is double wall. So what I'm gonna do is take some extra cardboardius and jam it down inside so that it's really good and thick. Like a guitar case, right? Excuse me while I'm down here. Like a dog. Come on. Right. And by adding this, the other thing we're doing is want to make sure there's absolutely no movement whatsoever in this box. So the guitar cannot wiggle around, it can't move. It has to be totally solid in there. If you don't have bubble wrap, a good substitute is crumpled up newspaper. You can make that work. Okay, so it's got, they'd have to poke like a spear through that to get through that. Now we have to fill in all the voids with bubble wrap so nothing moves in the box.
And in the middle of it all, there's always time for viewer mail. This one cracked me up, right? It's like, swarmcell.com, lip balms, beeswax, and all these funky flavors. I'm like totally impressed. And then he did the specialty ones. Gooch proof your lips. Yes, gooch proof your lips. Official lip balm of Dave's World of Fun Stuff. That's hilarious. Thanks, Dana. And like I said, you know, no good deed goes unpunished. So if my lips peel off up here in Canada with your chocolate chip beeswax on my face, I'll come and get you.
Okay, so here we have it. A million different arrows as to which way it should ride. Do not crush, because we know they're going to lay it this way. So when they do that, hopefully they see this and realize that they shouldn't stack all kinds of, you know, pallets of steel and shit all over it. Okay, next, some addressing and a little bit of customs paper.